Ernie er en udpræget swingmusiker og swingarrangør og har været tilknyttet Basie-organisationen i mange år og spillet med Count Basies orkestre. Og da han kom første gang her i, ja, det må være midt i 60'erne og spillede med Benoners orkester og skrev til ham, der var han skam en stor stjerne. Ikke det, men hvad sagt, at han ikke stadigvæk er det. Men altså, det var jo ikke så almindeligt på det tidspunkt, at der dukkede sådan nogle kapaciteter op lige pludselig og beskæftigede sig med os.
Og det er vel ikke med, at han er jo, han har en stor del af æren af den basselyd, som vi alle sammen kender fra 50'erne. Det er faktisk en stor del af hans arbejde, der ligger til grund for den lyd, som er så kendt, det og dannet en virkelig skole for virkelig big band lyd, ikke?
Ja, han har jo også skrevet til Disky Lesby
og Harry
James.
Hvis du spørger ham, så har han en liste på størrelse med Oscar Davidsons smørbrødsseddel. Last part of 69.
Good day, gentlemen. Bonjour, messieurs. We're going to start with Suite for Jazz Band number one. And we'll be stopping along the way when it's necessary. So we take it from the top and then stop at letter G, okay? In two. Let's just take the saxophones alone, just the letter G, and then the saxophones and the rhythm section at letter G. Okay, saxes alone. In two, three, four. Okay, saxes and rhythm now. In two, three, four. More bass drum.
Okay.
Kick it.
Yes, okay.
Okay. First, I want to hear the brass, the first four bars. First four bars of O without the rhythm. So I can hear the harmonies better without the rhythm section, okay? First four bars of O. Okay. In two, three, four. Okay. Now letter P. In two, three, four. What do you have?
It's a long tone.
You got along? All of you?
Trommeslageren er jo orkestrets ankermand, og du er ny i det her. Hvordan er det dog gået for dig i det her orkester? Hvad har du sådan oplevet som noget spændende for dig som trommeslager?
Jeg har oplevet, jeg har i hvert fald oplevet at møde et musikalsk bagland, som jeg ikke har haft mulighed for at beskæftige mig med i samme grad tidligere. Altså, for eksempel at nu for eksempel mødes en som Ernie, ikke, hvor man spiller den stil Ernie kommer ud Count Basie og den over, selvom han selvfølgelig har lavet sin egen drejning i musikken, så er det stadigvæk den stilart, som man bliver præsenteret for og får lov at dykke ind i. Det går mere og mere op for mig, hvor stor en indflydelse altså sådan noget big band trommespil faktisk har på jazz trommespil, som det er i dag. Og det synes jeg er nogle penge at møde.
But this one is F-sharp, but it doesn't move.
No, it ain't making it.
No, so I just wanted to know, all the others has blah, 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 yeah. Down and up.
Yeah, second apart, minor second.
About this one should be
E natural. E natural to F.
Yeah, should I do that?
Yes. Let me see.
The first big name band that I went with was Count Basie himself, you know.
When was it?
In 1951. And I had been playing with the local bands around St. Louis, although before then I had been writing for Earl Hines' last big band. I was arranging for Earl Hines' band before he joined Louis Armstrong's group in 1947. And so then I was fooling around in St. Louis through the late 40s until Clark Terry told Count Basie about me when Basie was reforming his big band. Because in 49 and 50, Basie had a sextet. You remember that sextet?
Yes.
Buddy DeFranco and Waldo Gray and Clark and all those. And so that was my first real job playing and writing for a name band like Count Basie's band. You know, we were all self-taught back in those days. We didn't have teachers. There was no schools for learning how to write. You know, not jazz. We all learned the hard way, just from listening and learning from the older musicians and listening to the records and trial and error. Write something, take it to rehearsal. If it's not good, tear it up and try again, you know.
For how many years have you been living in Copenhagen?
Over 10 years now. I moved here for good in January 1980. Jenny and the kids came over a few months before I did because I had some things to do back in New York. Then I was here January 1980 for good.
And then you started the Almost Big Band. Isn't it your first orchestra?
Yeah, it's my first band ever.
Yes.
And that was in 1980, 6 months after I moved here, I had the Almost Big Band. And certain things that happened over here that were not happening for me in the USA. In fact, before we decided to move here, I had become a bit unhappy about what I was doing in the USA. Wasn't really doing what I wanted to do. I was working for other people. I had fun playing with Clark Terry's big band, but some of the other things, I had to teach a lot, and I wasn't making any records. I could not get any record company interested in getting me to record. Since I've been here, I have four albums out, four albums and a CD with Almost Big Band.
Du gør sakserne klar. Der kommer bariton lead på det næste her, og indimellem er der kok, bras, og husk at give trompeterne en lille smule mere, når de kommer ind her om et øjeblik.
Det er massen først.
Der er sakserne på nu. Så kommer braset. Så går baritonen lige i overkanten. Nemlig. Og så åben bras nu ellers. Besvælge personerne. Pas på. Ja. Gør personerne en lille smule ned. Yes. Og så anden alten sammen med trompeterne, og Uffe Markussen, tenoren, gør klar over på fløjen. Han rejser sig op nu. Og det laver vi en gang til. Kommer du her. Sammen med bassen, og så kommer hele orkestret ind og spiller frit i to takter, og så...
Ja. Er åben, ikke?
Ja, fuld knald på. Kommer her. tilbage til tenorer. Ja. Og en gang til. Solo. Og så tilbage til de to trompeter og Jansson Forte, midt af alten, lidt ned med ham.
I wrote the first two parts of the jazz suite either 1961 or 1962. Now that's 28, 29 years ago. This is unbelievable. Then something happened, my first wife and I, we had to move or something, and I forgot about that music, forgot about it. All those years, the music was just lying around. And last year, the man that was working with me at the time, he was my copyist, the man that copied the parts from the score, the parts for the orchestra, you know. He sent me a tape that I had forgotten about also of the first two parts of the suite. And when I played the tape, I flipped. I said, I can't believe what I'm hearing. It was supposed to have been in three parts in the beginning, but I never got around to writing a third part in 28 years. So I finally wrote the third part this year. And I think that's an unbelievable story that it would take me almost 30 years to finish a piece of music. But it's true. It's just the way it happened.
Okay, gentlemen, we shall now play the new part, which is part number 3. Nikolai? showbiz.